This is the story of trying to do a project really quickly and screwing it up a lot.
I've been using this wire shelf as a stand for a computer for measuring things, and that's come in handy, but it's not the ideal platform.
And years ago, I hacked together this really skinny little table on wheels, so I figured I should make another one for this setup here.
This piece of shelving is supposed to be the top, and the next thing I did is I cut these legs just from pieces of 2x4, and then I planed them. But my planer was still in this state here because I'd previously shot a thumbnail when I made a video about this box here, and for that I had it turned on and cranked down hard on the wood so that this indicator needle was up. So without thinking, I set to plug it in, but the planer was switched on, not just that, but it was actually stalled hard on this piece of wood because it was cranked way down on it, so it couldn't turn, so it just hummed and there was a huge spark at the plug.
So I unplugged it immediately, and fortunately, nothing was damaged.
So I turned it off, backed it out, got this piece out, and then I was ready to plane. Except I was thinking, man, the dust collection on this seems to be working rather poorly as I was planing these legs, not realizing I forgot to open the blast gate. Whoops. I then joined these apron pieces to the legs using four dowels in here, using this dowel jig, except one time I put it on in the opposite orientation that I thought I had and drilled a hole, so I got a couple of spare holes here. Whoops. But then to join these pieces on here to make the square apron for the table, I wanted the dowels to be offset from the four that I already had in there, so I wouldn't be drilling through the dowel but actually be putting them in between, so that inside this leg the dowels would essentially cross each other like this, and I had to think about that carefully.
But it was a Friday afternoon, and once the kids are home on a Friday afternoon, I don't get to do any more work until Monday, so I was in a hurry and there was no time to think.
And I used this drill guide to position the drill correctly, and of course I have to make sure I don't drill all the way through, so I had this piece of wood that I had to remember to put on the drill every time to drill through, except one time I forgot and I drilled through here like this, and drill came out the other side, drilled into my table saw. Oops. And I did that twice. Here's the other hole. When I drilled these holes, I had them on the workbench pretty side up. But of course, if the holes are drilled on this side, that makes this the inside, which means now the ugly side is on the outside. Oh well. And then I worked out where I had to position the jig on the end of this piece here to drill those holes. Except I measured the wrong offset, so the holes I drilled on the end of this thing here to join on here are in the wrong place, so no problem, I'll just cut off a piece and I'll re-drill. And these ones still don't really match, so no problem, I'll just cut this off again. But now this piece had gotten too short for joining here, so I had to make new pieces, these ones here.
But by then it was 4 o'clock and I realized there's no way I can finish this before the weekend. And now it's Tuesday and cooler heads prevail, I hope. So I decided to make a video about this after all, because before I was just in a hurry, just get this thing done, no video. But in hindsight now, the screw-ups are funnier when I'm not actually doing them, which is why I decided to make a video about that.
Now to drill holes in here that line up with the ones here, I've got my dowel jig here with a dowel in it, and I'll just put that in one of the holes here. And that tells me where that jig was when I drilled the holes. And now I need to measure this distance here. And that's how far from the edge this needs to be on these pieces to get the holes in the right spot. So those two holes line up pretty good. Now the last hole. I'll put that in here. And again, measure how far from the end I am with the jig. And I think I screwed up last time by measuring this offset like this, where it should have been like this. And you might notice this piece is a bit thinner than this piece, or at least on this end it is. On the other end, not so much, because I kind of freehand cut that down the middle with a bandsaw and then passed it over to a jointer to smooth it, so these should be the outside.
Unless, of course, I end up gluing them on backward.
And when cutting dowels on the bandsaw, it's important to hold them really firmly, otherwise this happens. And I did that twice. And I ended up gluing these on the right way around. In fact, that whole glue-up proceeded surprisingly smoothly. This piece here has got holes in it for attaching the tabletop. I could attach the tabletop with pocket holes too, but I'd rather restrict my screw-ups to unintentional ones. And the minor screw-up, this ended up being not quite flush with the legs, so I'll just fix that with a hand plane. And now adding a round over to the legs, that would of course have been easier before I put it together. I thought I was done with the really bad screw-ups, but look at this. What happened is the guide bearing fell off the router. I'll just have to put that back on. And the screw, of course. Now I want to put these wheels on the bottom here, but rather than just drill in the middle of this, I'm going to put a piece of hardwood there. And that's going to tie two legs together like this. And the reason I cut out the way I did is that way I can get two of these pieces out of that same piece of hardwood. So just put that together this way to check the height. That's a bit higher than this. I think I need to shorten those legs. So I just moved stuff from here to here, and I realized I need a space for all this mess of wiring. So I just glued together a cable tray to go underneath the table. Now with the cable tray installed, that takes care of most of the cabling mess. This is sort of my lab cart, and I've been using that to do fast current measurements of different things. So turning on this 1400 watt space heater goes this far, and this is 15 amps here. But if I turn on this circular saw, you can see that surged way, way, way up, more than three times the capacity of the socket. And I'm going to make a video on that stuff sooner or later, but I'll put it on my Matthias Random Stuff channel, where I put my non-woodworking content. And if numbers and measurements interest you, here's two more videos where I'm measuring stuff with this Raspberry Pi computer.